morning, rebels. Good morning, good morning, good afternoon. Ground, whatever it is, wherever you are. Hello. Oh, welcome to the last day of power. Welcome. Thank you so much for taking the time to be here with me today. I'm feeling so excited, so lit up. I'm gonna light a candle just to alchemize and to have that energy here with us. Feeling so much gratitude for all of you today, for all of you watching the recording, for over 1,500 of you saying yes to this experience, to choosing in, to finding the power within you. So, so, so powerful. So we're just gonna begin like we began every other class, rubbing our hands together, really collecting this energy that we have found, the energy that we're finding, the energy within ourselves. Filling and filling and filling and filling the energy in our hands, holding it at heart center, taking a big inhale in through our nose, expanding in our bellies, sipping at the top, a little bit more, holding and exhaling. Two more, inhale. Sipping, allowing the oxygen to fill every space in that body. Sipping and sipping, holding at the top and exhale. And one more time, inhale. Sipping, sipping, sipping. Calling upon our angels and guides, calling upon our ancestors, calling upon the goddesses who have helped us reclaim their example, their power into ourselves, knowing they're just a mirror for us. Calling upon the internet gods, thanking them for this clear connection for women to be able to hear what exactly it is that they need to hear from all over the world, calling on our highest selves to know that only what is for our highest good is in this space. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Just gonna drop some kapal here and send a quick text to my husband to remind the construction guys to go on an early lunch break. Cause I can hear them still. I don't know, can you guys hear that in the background? Can you hear that? Perfect. I mean, there's nothing going on in the background. I don't know why I even said that. Okay. Really quick. God bless them. God bless them and their work. Okay. Whew. Welcoming in all of you. How are we feeling? How are we feeling? How are we feeling? Feeling the energy? Wow. The energy of this space is so absolutely powerful. The women of this space, you, your energy, I can feel it so beautifully. Like, I like love to scoot up closer to the camera so I can just like see your faces and you can feel mine. Yeah, feeling so good, fantastic, renewed, elevated, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Well, here we are, day three. So let's get after it, shall we? You know, it's interesting because with all of these containers, with all of these classes, I'm just an instrument and a vessel, really, with my whole business in general. All of us are just vessels. And the more that we attune to our unique frequency, the more we really understand the uniqueness of ourselves, the more that frequency will be felt. The more we'll understand what we can give to the world, right? But remembering, we can only give to ourselves first in this space. So as we attune to our frequency and as you guys kind of understand really what that means and what that potentially is for you, we're gonna ask, or I'm gonna ask, we as in the instrument that I am for God and Goddess, I have a couple questions just to begin the class today. And then we're gonna go in. We are going in again, yeah? But I wanna start, and there's a reason why I didn't start power with these questions, because I'm sure you've noticed by now, but power is subjective. Your power. It means different, something different to everybody, right? And so as we really tune into wrapping up the energy of understanding what that is, and we're not really ending anything. In fact, this is just the beginning for all of us, the beginning to tap into really what this means for us, what this means for the people that say yes to Sacred Rebels, what this means for you saying yes to yourself for this training and then continuing onward, right? So as we think about that, I want you just to close your eyes for a minute. And I want you to think about what the word power means to you. What does the word power mean to you? And when you have it, maybe even just a glimmer of it, maybe just write it in the comments or in your journal. What does the word power mean to you? Beautiful. I love that there's a lot of just clear and crisp answers. Autonomy, love, impact, freedom, authenticity, strength, confidence. Authenticity, yeah. Freedom, strength, living authentic. Beautiful. Love and freedom, boundaries, security. Stillness, showing up for myself, loving myself. To be truly and authentically yourself. I love that we are redefining what the word power means, because I think that a lot of times, especially in this world, that word has really gotten a bad rap. And I think that there's a reason for that. If you look at anything that's really powerful, like really anything that gives us back our power, whether it's abundance and money, or whether it's sexuality, they have been really demonized for us to maybe look away from them. How could we really harness our power? How could we actually become powerful? That means that other people are gonna feel less, or maybe that means that people are gonna think bad of us. Maybe think people will think that we're prideful or boastful, or who does she think she is? That's what they used to tell us, right? But we're beginning to realize is that power means none of those things. It means none of those things. And our words are spelling our spells. And they've been really tricky. And when I say they, I mean literally whoever you think is the opposition of your power. Anyone. Because we do have to see the authenticity of the opposition for us to really strengthen ourselves, where we've kind of allowed our power to go somewhere else. And there's bitterness and rage there. How could they? How could they believe that I, by standing in my power, I was taking away from somebody else? Well, none of us are gonna realize what is on the other side of that until we actually choose into showing up authentically. Instead of saying, no more of this, no more of somebody telling me what the definition of power is. No more of somebody telling me that if I stand in my power.
Just watch a movie, loving.
Yes, another mom. Just watch a movie, it's fine. I'm learning about my power. I love it so much. I see you, Rachel. Now is the time that instead of allowing ourselves to believe what other people told us to believe, that our power is based out of pride or selfishness, we get to change it. And that's why I love your guys' answers. And actually your answers will probably be the same to the next question I have, which is, what is power to you? What is power to you? So what does the word power mean to you? And what is power to you? Now they might seem like the same question, but they're not. What is power to you might be that answer might be from a conditioned belief. But what power is to you, the meaning of power could be something different than the opposite. And also we realize, you guys already did it, you already beat me to it, they're the one and the same. So as we define ourselves by our own understanding of power, being strong enough to know who I am, freedom, authenticity, being connected with God, strength, no apology for being myself. Notice how none of the answers for those two questions that seemingly are super similar had anything to do with people judging you for showing up, with people judging you for sharing your medicine, with people judging you for sharing your frequency, right? None of that is even there. And it, in fact, it can't. It can't be there, because when you're living in your authentic truth, what happens is authenticity is the highest, most profound boundary you could ever give. Because with authenticity comes accountability. And when we stand in our truth, our frequency shines so bright that we don't allow anybody else in our frequency to convince us otherwise. So I love all of these: inner strength, authenticity. So if you could define it with one word, you already have, what would it be? To you. We're doing it over and over. We're really just like locking it in. Conduit. Oh, I love that word. Alignment, ease, beautiful, confidence, peace. Me, beautiful. I love that. Voice, purpose, connection, boundaries. Yeah. Yeah, beautiful. So I want you to think about the word that you finally locked in. And then I want you all to write down one way you're already embodying that word. So Mandy, how are you embodying authenticity? Cody, how are you embodying purpose? Beatrice, how are you embodying life? Being the phone call to heaven, having awareness. Saying no when it's not meant for me. Human design, understanding that. Boundaries, taking care of my body. Yeah, embracing all the feminine, masculine energy within me. Mm-hmm. Yep, letting my heart see my external and internal. Making choices for myself and my company that I know are right, even when others don't understand or agree. Absolutely. Hallelujah, amen. Embracing rest. So the beautiful part about power and about what we're doing here right now is we are integrating what we've learned over the last 2 days on the very, very, very short of time. I tried to sink in and make as much concentrated content for you guys as possible. But ultimately, like I said, as being the instrument to your own power, you're already seeing that you're already doing that. That is the gift. That is the key to manifestation, is realizing that you already have that power in here. And sure, we did the hero exercise and we talked about our pain to purpose, but embodying this. So how often are you connecting to your breath, Brooke? And Annabelle, how many times are you making choices based off of self-alignment? These are your calls to action. This is you stepping in to say, okay, this is your intention of power. No more sugarcoating, Natalia. Natalie says, connecting to my own intuition. How often are you doing that? Lacey, allowing myself to learn and step into new, facing fear with hope. That's a huge call. And notice that you guys didn't hesitate, because you're already in that frequency of power. Because saying yes to a container like this, saying yes to saying, yes, I'm going to do this training, does something to you. You felt it. Didn't you feel it? You're like, oh, wait. Because I said yes, I all of a sudden am like connected even deeper. Because I took time for myself and sat here, I said, okay, hang on. The threads are connecting. Joanna says to jump. What's you jumping on, Joanna? Daily, yes, beautiful. Sitting with the uncomfort, Gina. How often are you allowing yourself to really go there? Gina, I haven't seen you on this live this whole time. I met Gina in Scotland. I love you, Gina. I don't know where you're at. I don't see your face, but oh, there you are. I love you. Beautiful. I love seeing so many familiar faces of people I didn't know. even jump on the live. I really want you to sink this in. I'm kind of going fast so we can slow down a little bit because I'm getting so excited because literally everything you're already doing is your call to the definition of what power means to you. I'm going to help you kind of lock this in a little bit more with me explaining kind of quickly the four T's. And if you've heard it before, listen again, because like I said, it's different. The things I've taught in this training, I've taught a million times and also I've never taught before. Because when we're saying yes to the present moment, this is why I love life coaching so much. We really hear things so much differently. So much differently, because today you're different than when you said yes 2 days ago. Like, imagine me asking you these questions at the very beginning. I know that we haven't had a lot of time together, but I know you also have felt it, felt the difference in who you are and how you feel and the power that you're feeling within yourself. So I'm going to go back to authenticity for just a second, because really the definition of authenticity is just genuinely just read the comments. Just read the comments, whatever is for your own unique frequency, which is literally already embodied in you. And of course there's nuances like your astrology and your human design and your soul and your gene keys, the way of your soma, your childhood years. But the cool thing about authenticity and accountability is that once you realize you, the accountability piece is powerful, because once you realize you have the power already to choose into your most authentic self, even if you maybe didn't think that you knew, breadcrumbs will start to happen where you'll notice that everything in your life leading up to this has been because of everything that you already are. And if you choose to realize the magic of everything that's weaved, all the pain and all of the happiness and all of the joy, that is the medicine within you. So your frequency, your authenticity. Yeah, just dropping incredible truth bombs. Wow, making me so emotional. Thank you for being here. Thank you. So your authenticity comes from your frequency. And when I say frequency, I literally mean, I know you guys don't need to know this, but I'm going to say it anyway. Everything's energy. It starts with energy, literally everything. From the computer screen, to my words, to the clothes on my skin, to me, this meat suit, this cosmic meat suit, right? The more we work on finding that unique frequency by reclaiming the power within us and remembering the power within us, the more we step into our authentic self. And here are four easy ways, I mean, to define how to help step into that. I love these, the four T's. Who's new to the four T's? Raise your hand. Oh, sweet, love it. First one's truth, your truth. How do you find your truth? There's something that I teach in Sacred Rebels called the Tree of Truth. And it's literally this beautiful visualization that I've created to understand that obviously the truth and what you're sharing is out in the leaves, but where it comes from is deep in the roots. So what is it that you believe? One example or one maybe takeaway or challenge you guys can have after this experience is sitting with the truths that you believe. Literally as simple as starting with, I believe that I love chocolate milk. Meditating on that, asking yourself if you actually believe that, and then actually seeing if that's true, listening to your higher self, and then writing down the answer. Going as deep as, I actually believe I have power. Really detailed beliefs, really detailed beliefs. I believe my higher self is what? I believe God is a man. I believe Jesus is who? Asking yourself the hard, difficult questions. Now, okay, so that's truth. Trusting yourself. And the more that you dive into being accountable for your authenticity and really step into these actual actions that you're already doing to step into your power, the more you do that, the more you trust yourself. The more you do that, the more you trust yourself. So yeah, the truth, like you said, Natalie, is reprogramming your beliefs or just seeing them. You might be digging in there, digging in the trenches and digging in those roots and being like, oh shit, I did not know that that root was there. It's thick, it's big. This is the belief of that. Okay, I'm gonna continue to pull it. And we teach that, the subconscious reprogramming in Sacred Rebels. So truth and trust, trusting yourself. Transparency, being so real with yourself, honoring the shadow of who you are, trusting that it's okay that you have the shadow. And the last one is totality, the masculine and feminine within you, honoring both of them completely. Really, really quick, easy way to bring that forward, to bring you to your authenticity. I wanted to give you guys those action items since power is ending and Sacred Rebels is beginning, and we get to continue to be together in that frequency. I'm calling it in, all of us together. So now that you have that and you've written it all down, the other way I really, really, really love to get to the root of our power. And no matter how many times I do this exercise, I find yet another layer. Yeah, Jihan, I love it. Sacred Rebels is the best investment I've ever made. Yeah. Trusting that it's okay to have that shadow. Yeah, Beatrice, absolutely. Yep. Yeah, the totality of it all. So whenever you're done writing notes, we're gonna start with our eyes closed. I'm gonna take you to a place for a second. We're gonna go to a couple places today. Let's travel the ethers a little bit. We love to time travel here. The four T's, just in case you didn't get them, were trust, truth. I think I put truth first, I'm so sorry. Truth, trust, transparency, and totality. And when you're done writing those, just let go of your notebook, step away from the computer, just so you can hear me. I'm gonna adjust the sound a little bit so we can get some music here.
Some just in that shower right there, probably on the ground.
Yeah, probably on the ground. Okay. And what we're doing here, we're gonna have a little conversation. Little conversation with ourselves, with our higher selves. And this conversation is gonna help us step in a little bit further to our power. And not just do that, but remove masks. Not for anybody else, but for ourselves. Because somewhere, sometime, we felt like we had to put a mask. Had to put on a mask. Music too loud. Ashley, how's the music? The music isn't loud, but it's making your voice quiet. Okay. I want you to be able to hear both of them. We love a technical difficulty. We love it. Don't worry about it. I'll have my assistant help me. Thank you so much for everybody willing to help me. Just focus on settling it. And if you're driving, don't go take it to it. Just listen to me. Okay. Just start to calm your nervous system by increasing your inhales and your exhales. Just settling into your body. If you haven't yet done that today, grounding yourself into the earth. Noticing the space right below your nose and right above your upper lip. Quieting quieting the body, stilling the body. Telling yourself you're safe to let go of this physical realm for just a moment. Take a big inhale to fill up your belly and just exhale it there. Really bringing stillness and awareness, feeling the clothes on your skin. Feeling the power. The power of who you are. Power of maybe who you're wanting to become. And as you start to feel that, as you start to understand this energy of who you want to become, as you keep your eyes closed, you notice in front of you a being appears. Your higher self. What does she look like? And this is your higher self in 1 year. You in 1 year. What does she look like? What does she sound like? What's her posture look like? What are her hands doing? Where are her shoulders? Is there a smile on her face? How's the energy around her? What is she wearing? Now that you have her in front of you, I want you to take a minute to also visualize right next to her, your highest self. Is she different? Does she look different? What is different about her? On your next breath, I invite you to allow yourself to bring both of these beautiful, wise women together into one actualized form. I want you to look at her for a moment. Really look at her. This is you in a year. Removing all space and time, removing all limitations, removing whatever it is that you think in your mind, wait, that can't be true. You get to actualize it right now. Don't sell yourself short. Go there, feel her, see her. Really see her. And when she's there, with a smile on her face, she slowly starts walking over to you. Exactly where you are, sitting in your family room or in your car or on your work break or in your office, with your babes on your feet, your dog in your lap, wherever it is you are. She's coming over to you now. Keeping your eyes closed, you feel her. You feel her presence. Allowing her to come closer and closer, she kneels down to you. And she looks at your face She looks in your eyes. And asks you, why are you hiding? Why are you hiding? And you answer her. And she says, baby girl, there's no need for that mask anymore. Let me help you remove it. Remember this time last year when I helped you remove it? Remember what happened? Remember where we went? And she places her hands up to your face. And gently remove the heaviness of that mask that no longer serves you. The heaviness of the mask that no longer has a space or a place, that no longer keeps you safe. And you let out an exhale of relief. I've been holding on to that for so long, you say. And maybe you don't know what it is. Maybe you don't know. Maybe it has no definition. But energetically, you feel lighter. And she looks at you in her eyes, and you look at her in hers. And she says to you, we did it. We're doing it. Notice, trust yourself, feel it. She puts her hand on your heart. And you put your hand on her heart and you notice they beat the same. There is no difference between you and her. In fact, the only difference is that she allows herself to trust and live in her authenticity, in her power. Allowing herself to be seen, allowing herself to take risks on herself, allowing herself to say yes to the things that terrify her. And as you connect together, you notice someone else in the room. Keeping your eyes closed, maybe just notice that someone else just on your right side. And then you start to notice and feel who it actually is. It's your younger self. It's your younger self who had to put the mask on in the first place. And you see her with her mask or her masks or the heaviness she's holding to protect herself, to help her feel safe. And you and your higher self go over to her and bend down and say the same thing to her. There's no need for these masks. Here, let me help you remove it. And with each mask you remove, you bury it into the ground, allowing it to alchemize and to fertilize this tree of truth that you live in, this tree of truth that you are planting, because you are not afraid to look at your roots anymore. In fact, you're willing to see them and plant them and water them even deeper than ever before. Because now you feel safe to live in your authenticity. And with this next song I'm going to sing, I want you to stay there with them. Stay there with your younger self, with yourself now and your higher self. And I want you to have a conversation of peace and power. I want you to visualize you being one together with them all. Burying the masks. Go to your forest together. And if more masks come, allow them to be removed. Speak to them. Thank them. Take the time now to bury what no longer serves you.
Enter the wild with care, my love, and speak the things you see. Let new names take and root and thrive and grow. And even as you travel far from heather, crag, and river, may you, like the little fisher, set the stream alight with glitter. May you enter now as otter, without falter, into water. Look to the sky with care, my love, and speak the things you see. Let new names take and root and thrive and grow. And even as you journey on, past dying stars exploding, like the gilded one in flight, leave your little gifts of light. And in the dead of night, my darling, find the gleaming eye of starling. Like the little aviator, sing your heart to all dark matter.
As you're planting, you notice that the six hands come to two, because you come together, embracing each other. And instead of saying goodbye, you say hello and embrace each other.
Walk through the world with care, my love, and sing the things you see. Let new names take and root and thrive and grow. And even as you stumble through Macher sands eroding, let the fern unfurl your grieving, let the heron still your breathing, let the selkie swim you deeper. Oh, my little silver seeker, even as the hour grows bleaker, be the singer and the speaker, and in city and in forest, let the larks become your chorus. And when every hope is gone, let the raven call you home.
And after you're done planting, you look up and there's a mirror in front of you. And you realize that highest self, that higher self, that person you aspire to be is exactly who you are now. Is exactly who you've been searching for. You feel her. You're ready to feel her. You place your hands on your chest. Maybe just maybe, you start to believe it. You start to believe that you're ready. You start to believe the power within you. You start to believe that it can be weaved into every area of your life, in your home, in your business, bigger than you've ever dreamt. Placing your hands at your heart center. Just feeling and noticing the energy. noticing and feeling yourself here now. Noticing and feeling how powerful you feel now. Opening your eyes for just a moment, staying here in this frequency. We're gonna go back. I wasn't expecting to do this, but here we are. And I just want you to feel this and see this and see this wall. See this and imagine. Just imagine for a moment your name on that wall, in your power. And I don't care if you've never made a single dime in your life. I don't care if you make multiple million dollars a year. You are a sacred rebel just for finding your power. Just for feeling it. And just for a moment, I want you to notice what it would feel like to put your name, to have your name here, to dedicate an entire year to really feeling what it feels like to step into your power. Close your eyes for a minute, and I'm gonna take you down that place where we let go. We let go of so much more, or we continue this energy of power, where we understand the altars of our hearts and the altars in our home, where we let go of fears and understand, actually educate ourselves on our fears, where we understand the breath, where we breathe more abundance into our homes and into our business, where we understand our bodies are the earth, where we really establish beauty and wonder in our business, our stories, coming home to our stories, realizing our story, absolutely should be weaved into what we do to create abundance into our lives. Not feeling shameful for any of it. Getting the foundations of everything put in place for our business, going onto our minds, the air, feeling the air coming in and out of your mouth and noticing that that is just a physical representation of the air that floats all around us and in you, and that is the magic and wonder that comes and moves through your mouth. Understanding belief systems, understanding how powerful it is to reprogram your mind, the inner child, the shadows and the emotions of it all. And then allowing that to weave into your business with your content and your mission statement, your values and your whys, your zone of genius and your content creation. And then your water soul, understanding what it means on the soul level to connect to whatever it is, your highest self, your God, universe, and weaving that into the magic of what you're bringing into the world. Your astrology, your human design, your gene keys, connecting to the essence of your physical blueprint, and then bringing that into your courses, your creations, literally birthing them. And finally, connecting to your womb, cycle syncing, yoni germering, understanding your sexuality is your power. Your abundance and wealth giving you insanely powerful abundance codes. Going deeper to learn about your business, your unique frequency, the marketing and the launching of every intricate detail to get you to the next step. Maybe you've dreamt of creating a retreat or getting women together or gathering women just like you feel here. Codes are waiting for you. One-on-one coaching, creating more abundance in your business, whether you're a real estate agent, a mom, a nurse, or just someone that maybe for the first time ever, you're actually feeling like you have power to work on you, to feel you, feel that energy. Feel the magic, feel this community right here, because this community is an extension of what it feels like to be held by sisters for an entire year. What a gift to ask any question you desire, to feel like you're seen and witnessed and heard, to have an opportunity to sit together in in-person experiences, to sing together, to cry together, to hold each other's hands through this beautifully painful, chaotic, crazy, expansive life. Just feel it. Feel it for a moment. Allow yourself to go there. Allow yourself to say, okay, wow, maybe I do deserve it. Maybe I am ready. Maybe it is time for me. Just hold it there for a moment. And then I want you to place your arms around you and just thank yourself. Oh, for being brave, for even considering such a powerful experience, for even considering that you're worthy of taking a chance on yourself, because you are. And I think maybe now, maybe for some of you, for the first time ever, you actually believe. Placing your hands back on the center of your chest. Raising them up to your third eye. For kind thoughts. Down the center of your lips for kind words. And down to your heart. For kindness and power to yourself always, then to others. Bringing yourself completely and fully back into the present. I'm not going to say namaste yet. We're not done yet. But just bringing yourself back here, more fully aware, more fully aligned, more fully in your power. How are we feeling? How are you feeling? Maybe before you write in the comments, I just want you to start to notice how you are feeling. Maybe you feel a little ringing in your ears or tingling in your fingertips. The world looks brighter. Oh, that makes me emotional. Yeah. We don't realize these subconscious, invisible masks. We don't realize what it's actually removing, dimming, hiding from us. Ready to believe in myself, hopeful. I'm ready to shine, beautiful, proud of myself, warm, energetic, and clear, whole and complete. Yeah. Completely forgot I was in a classroom. Wait, I wanted to read what else she wrote. Oh, I can't find it. Oh, it doesn't matter. It's so cute. Believe right in the class, feeling so empowered and sparkly. Love that. Sacred rage, beautiful, beautiful. For me, alchemizing fuel, incredible. I witness all of you and how you feel in this moment. Whatever it is that you're feeling, however it is that you're feeling, I want to welcome you into this feeling of power, into this feeling of your unique frequency. And I'm telling you right now, I am telling you, and I know this is a large claim, but I am telling you, if you take the things that you learned and heard over these 3 days, it will drastically change your life. If you stand in your accountability and believe in your authenticity, yes, even when the Zoom call goes off, even when the babies wake up and they're crying, even when you have to go and make dinner, even when someone's rude to you at the grocery store, remembering your authentic frequency through every breath and every step and every messy experience will change everything. And literally, there's nothing else but action now. Action, however that looks for you, however that looks for you. Action in whatever it is. So beautiful. Ready to trust myself again. So grateful for this experience. I am so grateful you guys all said yes to each other and to yourselves and to this container. The energy is felt. I'm a different person than when I started. Thank you. Yeah. And I would be so bold to say that all of you, in one way or another, are ready to say yes to Sacred Rebels. Yes, yes, yes. The link will be sent to you via email. We have a pre-launch price till next Thursday. If you follow me, you'll see me share all about it. I cannot wait for Sacred Rebels. This has been life-changing. I'm so excited as well. And honestly, you guys, I'm so excited to write your names on that wall. I'm actually not gonna write them this year. I'm gonna do something different. So stay tuned for that if I can figure it out. The visualization of my house self was so powerful. The combination of both my feminine and masculine, and they coexist. Sparks were flying. It makes me excited. Yeah, I can see your name on that wall too. So beautiful. Okay, so before we say goodbye. Okay, I know that a lot of people are new to this container. So I was gonna say, you guys know what to do. I actually didn't tell Ashley to do this. Ashley, oh, let's answer some questions first. And I have to answer the $111 winner too. Let's see, when does Sacred Rebels meet? So live, we meet every third Wednesday live, and it's different times, different on different days, on different months, because we have people from women from all over the world. And then all the information's also on the landing page. Full-time nurse here, would Sacred Rebels still be beneficial? Absolutely. So that's what's so interesting about what I've created here, because, and if you guys haven't listened to my last podcast, it'll help you, but it's literally for everybody, and it'll meet you exactly where you are in your life. And those of you that are Sacred Rebels or who were Sacred Rebels last year can attest to that. That women from multi-million dollar companies came in and got to know themselves better than ever before. And women who are full-time nurses who are just wanting support from sisterhood to learn more about themselves also got what they needed as well. Medicina is the same but different. Medicina is the grandmother ayahuasca retreat that I put together with my incredible, incredible shamans and team. The next Medicina is actually the first weekend of May. We do it in a private ranch in Southern Utah. And if you're wanting more information on that, you can just DM me and we are filling applications for that. You have to apply for that actually. You don't have to apply for Sacred Rebels. If you feel called to it, it's there for you. Details on my top are, it's Nordstrom Rack. Thank you very much. And it comes with a skirt that I did not wear today because no one's got time for a skirt when you're sitting on the ground. Let's see, any other questions before we go? Cute, Kristen, thanks for saying that. 1,000,000%, it's worth Sacred Rebels. Yeah, there's a big difference between Sacred Rebels and Medicina Retreat, yes. So they go hand in hand with finding yourself. Sacred Rebels is a year-long coaching container, year-long mastermind, and certification. The other thing that's really powerful is once you do the year-long, you get certified as an elemental life coach to literally teach what I teach in there. Medicina is a plant medicine retreat that's only for 5 days. Both very powerful, both help you find who you are. Yeah. There will be a Medicina retreat in the fall, yes. And there are scholarship opportunities for both. So the scholarship opportunities for Sacred Rebels is not by application, it's simply by engagement. I just want to be able to feel your energy and your frequency. That's what I do every time for containers. So what that means is, I will be posting a lot on Instagram. I'll be sharing a lot on Instagram. And I just want to be able to feel your energy and excitement about wanting to be in the container. So whether you like or comment, share it, save the post. The actual launch is open until March 8th. We have it open, but it's the only time it'll be open for the year. Sacred Rebels is only open once a year. And I do that purposefully. Some people would say it's not smart marketing-wise, but it's essential for me because what's cool about Sacred Rebels is I really blend feminine and masculine together, because you can have a coach that tells you all about the feminine flow, but if you don't have structure and schedule and like discipline, it won't work. So we are only open for 2024 until March 8th. So you guys can totally, it actually begins. So you guys can totally, sorry, I'm jumping ahead. So you can totally allow yourself to really feel into the frequency, comment, just like make yourself be known. Like, let me see you on Instagram, and then I'll be able to feel it. It's brilliant marketing. It's growing itself. Thank you. I've had really fun branding it. It's like my highest expression of self. It's been really fun. There is absolutely a payment plan. It's 11 payments for $555. So that's at the checkout page. And also it's the whole price right now until February 8th is $4,997, which is beautiful. And I love that I can price it that low, because it's not about necessarily the people, it's about, or you know, the small amount of people that can afford it. It's about the ripples, which is why I price it that much. In fact, my yoga teacher training alone was that expensive, which is really interesting because I teach you guys how to create yoga flows in Sacred Rebels if you desire. Let's see, I saw something else. Yeah, Jahan, thank you so much. It's worth 10 times that. Thank you. I feel that. I feel that too. But just because I can charge that much doesn't mean I'm going to, because I believe in the ripples. I believe in the ripples. The first call is February 15th. That's when we'll have our first opening live coaching call. And it'll feel a lot like this. I'm gonna get really deep and hippie in that space. I open the directions with my instruments, with Mapacho, with Sacred Mapacho, and I teach you all about that in there too. Just a little bit about me is I have been apprenticing with deep plant medicine elders for over 4 years now, almost 4 years, and they've taught me a lot about sacred space and creating it. So we get to bring that and mesh that into there. And yeah, it does certify you in yoga. Yes, it is. It does. I have women that have done Sacred Rebels that are now doing their own yoga flows. Yeah, that's part of the Earth Body Month. I teach you all about somatics. It's not required necessarily, but understanding the somatics, which is just movement, is how I teach yoga. Yeah. Let's see. So the certifications you get if you complete Sacred Rebels is you become an elemental life coach, and that certifies you to teach hypnotherapy, somatic movement, and rebel breath work. And then it also weaves you into helping your clients in a full embodied way. Because I don't believe life coaching is just like, oh, I'm gonna give you some tools and please journal and all those things. It's like, let's get it so that you're moving your body. Let's get it so that we work on your inner child through hypnotherapy. Let's get it so we learn about your human design and understand your physical body, right? Let's get it through your cycle syncing and understanding your womb and your sensuality and your sexuality. It's a full embodiment of the earth, air, water, and fire. Yeah. Amazing, amazing. Yeah, so all the certifications are through my trademark. They're not through Yoga Alliance, no. But I got my certification through Yoga Alliance years ago. And I've looked into becoming Yoga Alliance certified, and I have women from Sacred Rebels teaching in classes publicly, and I teach in classes all the time. So it's not beneficial in my opinion. Yeah. I decide the scholarship winners. It just depends. Like I'll just decide. I'm not just taking one. I'll take a few. It just really depends on like who I feel really called to. I just like let spirit guide me. And I'll pick the first one in like maybe a week, and then the next one in a couple weeks, so that there is still some time with like open enrollment that if you aren't picked, you can still say yes, this experience. I go over all of the business side of things, how to start your own practice. We literally have my lawyer that's involved. We have contracts that we give to you. We help you set up your LLC. We help you set up your email list, all those things. Oh my gosh, Turtle. Is that your name, Turtle? Because if it is, I'm so obsessed. Turtle's iPhone. I'm assuming that's not. I don't know if it is. I love it if it is. But I saw that you bought your Medicina ticket last night. I'm so excited. It's my nickname. I'm obsessed. I wish my nickname was Turtle. Welcome to Medicina. I'm so excited to have you. It's going to be so powerful. We're already almost halfway filled for Medicina. So yeah, you had no idea how in-depth this is. It's because, you guys, here's the truth. It's so hard to explain Sacred Rebels because unfortunately, whether this is, I don't know, it just is what it is. A lot of year-long containers don't have that. They just don't. And for me to explain, those that are on Sacred Rebels that have been here, for me to explain what is actually taught there is impossible. But I literally give you, it's literally a course a month. It's a course a month, and every single month you start with a monthly guide, and I give you the intention and challenges, and it's perfectly weaved into everything I teach. It's literally the 13 years of business and my life's work into one container. And instead of just like allowing the elemental life coaching piece to be one and then the business to be one, I had to put it all in one, even though people thought it was crazy. Yeah, you're literally taught everything you need to know and more. Yeah. I was trying to articulate it to my husband and I just can't quite nail it. I mean, yeah, in layman's terms, it's literally just the most epic mastermind certification you could ever be a part of, essentially. Really, really powerful. It's really exciting. I think also people don't understand because of the price point. Usually things like this are like 20 grand plus, but I'm just not gonna do that. At least not yet. I just don't feel like I want to. I want hundreds of women in there. This is why I put this together. I don't want you guys to have to go and spend thousands of dollars on hypnotherapy and $1,000 on yoga, thousands of dollars becoming trauma informed. I want to be able to give you everything and prayerfully have put this together over, this is my life's work, Sacred Rebels. And it gives you the foundation that you really want, even if you have a thriving business. I love it, love it, love it, love it. I started as someone just wanting to be a part of Sacred Rebels because FOMO. I finished a changed woman standing in my truth and helping others heal themselves. It's so worth it. Yeah. Really feeling the pull now. I love it. Love you. Yeah, absolutely. Trauma-informed is the number one most important part about all of those things. Because if you don't have that, what's even worth it? And Medicina changed your life. I love this. Okay. Okay, we're going ahead. Do we have any more questions? Oh, Ashley, I love you. For her to explain any of her containers is impossible. Words fall short every time. The experience is changed on a cellular level. I love you guys so much. Ashley, it was so good to see your face. Ashley was one of my Simply Wild backpacking girls. Slay. In fact, you can thank her for Sacred Rebels because as a projector, I have to be invited. I have to be invited into this spaces. I'm going to go over all this in Sacred Rebels. It's one thing we talk about. But every single thing I've created in my business is because someone has invited me in my community saying, oh, I want this. Like, what about this? Or what about this? I had been working on creating a certification program and a mastermind, a year-long mastermind for years, and it just never felt right. And then Ashley and all the girls at that specific Simply Wild Backpacking said, you have to do it. I want to know how do you do what you do. I want to learn from you. And that's it. That's how it happened. And last year was a huge, massive year of creation, a huge, massive year for me, really intense to create everything, but now the foundation's there and I just can't wait for all of the women to say yes, to continue to say yes. Yeah, beautiful. I do know a lot about reflectors. Yes, we'll go over that. Backpacking this year, I'm still not sure. I really, really want to do backpacking this year, but if I do, it'll be a little different. It's going to be more of a intimate high level mastermind where we add backpacking on at the end. So 12 women I work intimate with for like 3 months. Okay, guys, I love you all. We don't say goodbye yet. We have to do something together. Let me make sure I got all the questions. I love you all so much and I cannot wait to see you guys and your names on that wall. I almost told you what I'm going to do. I'm not going to tell you what I'm going to do. You just have to wait and see how I'm going to put your names up there. Jewel said, I literally had no idea what I was getting into signing up for Sacred Rebels last year. I thought I'd be learning and grow, scale my business. I'm a changed person. I can't even tell you. I can't even tell you the doors opened for me. I learned tenfold more than I ever thought I would. So grateful. Just do it. Love you, Jewel, so much. I love my Sacred Rebel OGs so much. They took such a risk saying yes to that container since it was new last year. And it was just such a powerful moment for all of us. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking. Ashley, will you put the lyrics for Longtime Sun in the comments? You already knew, of course. At the end of every class, if we have time, I like to sing this song together. And we sing it 3 times. One, yourself, once for the collective and once for the collective group, right? And another time for literally the world. May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. I love you all so much. I'll see you in Sacred Rebels. Yeah, sing along with me. empower women, all the women everywhere.
Breathe a long time sun, shine upon you, and all love surround you, and up your light within you. Guide your way.
One more time, singing it for this whole universe. You to the fullest expression of you. Finding who you are and never
forgetting.
Placing your hearts at heart center, placing your hands at heart center, knowing that you are never too much and always enough, and that I will get all of you guys the playlist for all these different songs, okay? Sorry, I meant to answer that. Knowing that you are never too much and always enough, knowing you have the power within you, you sacred rebel, to always know the medicine and your own unique frequency. My light and love honors and sees that unique frequency and medicine within you and never compares it. Namaste. I love you all so much. So powerful. Thank you so much for taking the time to be here. Love you all. Unmute yourselves. Oh wait, we didn't pick 111. Hold on. Ash, the winner. Oh, Casey Malik. Casey Malik with a C. Oh, hi, I see you. Okay, so just DM me, okay? And I'll Venmo that to you, okay? Okay. Okay, I love you guys. Unmute yourselves. Say goodbye. See you in Sacred Bye. Rebel.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you. I love
thank
you.
You. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you.
That's beautiful. Sick.
I like watching everybody leave. So bye. Thank you.
Hi, Sadie.
Dance party for those that are still here. Love you.